It's March 11th, smack dab between Punchy Day and Pie Day, during your Lenten sweet tooth. Captain, this is Make and Break. There are doubts regarding
your ability. Boom, the almighty KG from the CCB, representing with BDP all the way to the 2Gs, kicking it live, CCB in the house, yeah baby.
Yeah, this is the Scratch creator, Grand Wizard DJ Theodore. Much props to the Zulu Nation and to my man
Dan Calvin.
Keep it real, peace.
Yo, this is the funky alien TC Islam, world representative for the almighty universal Zulu Nation, coming through with the Blastmaster,
Daniel Calvin.
Zulu Nation BDP, roll forever, blast!
Super Rocket, Mr. Magic, back to
Dan Calvin.
Represent, yo, for the 9 pound on your hot 9-7.
Cool Herc, the godfather of hip-hop music, and my man Damn. Keeping it alive.
Yo, this is DJ Chuck Chill Out, and I'm live, you understand? And I'm checking out my main man,
Dan Calvin.
He's always keeping shit real, from the old to the new.
Yeah, this is MC Shan. I'm backstage with my man.
Damn.
And y'all don't believe the hype, because this is my man, yo. And I'm going to tell you, my man shit going to blow up this year. Y'all watch.
Chevy Chev, take the ladies to bed. And a Rockwell to the depths of hell. And a Dada Rocky hit the top and you don't stop. And Master Rob like down so folks eat corn on the cob. And whip a whip with the show shot shit. And yo, to my man Ruby D. Peace, Puerto Rico ho.
Yo, what's up? This is Scorpio representing the old school, the Panty Inspector. Hey, yo,
damn,
man, no more talking. Just bring it on.
Welcome to another great episode of Make and Break Radio. I've got some good tunes, stupid news, and you'll listen in live while I sort through the contents of my vacuum cleaner bag. So grab your Strohs and a chaser of Jaeger. Yeah, I said that right. So sit back and don't let your Mac burn your lap, because this show's gonna get hot. Making trouble news now, man broke into police station and made himself a bowl of porridge. A man has been arrested on suspicion of burglary after allegedly breaking into a police station in the middle of the night and helping himself to a bowl of porridge. Michael Allen, 23, was arrested at 4 a.m. on Saturday at a police station of a town that I won't even begin to try to pronounce, someplace in England. He is alleged to have been discovered wearing a cop's uniform and with a bowl of porridge and a cup of coffee. He was arrested after allegedly being discovered by a policeman coming on duty. It is claimed he was wearing a police helmet and jacket at the time. Mr. Allen of Barlow Road, Broadheath, Trafford, will appear at Trafford Magistrates Court on March 16th, charged with burglary. A door that was found broken is being fixed. The same station was at the center of a drama last month when it had to be evacuated after a man turned up with a hand grenade. Apparently their porridge was just right. Sometimes I have to stand up for my convictions and shop only at establishments that exploit women, the homeless, and large caged animals. This hour of Make and Break Radio is brought to you by Homes Brick Hardware of Wadsworth, Ohio. The local source for your needs such as hose, black nipples, ball cocks, nuts, excellent screws, and all types of female-to-male adapters. Mackinac Island News now. We finally had some snowfall, resulting in a mammoth influx in Yeti and other snowbee sightings. The Blair's Cold Cellar was ransacked by somebody possessing enormous ape-like feet. Prints left in the snow, entering and exiting the cellar, indicated as much. 3 quarts of beets were found to be missing. Mrs. Andrick claims that her Yorkshire Terrier Limpy was absconded with.
by a large, hairy simian creature. Fortunately, she got a good look at the horrific sight before the giant ran off. The suspect is about 7 foot 4 inches tall, 600 pounds, wore a beard, and atop his head was a baseball-style cap, she said, that had "Diesel Fumes Make Me Horny" written above the bill. If you have any information regarding Limpy's abduction, please contact us at the Make and Break Radio News Team via email. That's Jim@MakeBreakShow.com. Jim@MakeBreakShow.com.
Welcome back to the Real Straight Stock with Daniel Sir Six-A-Lot Kelvin.
The views expressed on the Straight Stock may not be the views of the Make and Break staff or the RadioMackinac.org management.
I'm going to give it to you straight.
We are under attack. Our borders have been compromised. Illegal aliens are destroying our picturesque island and its bucolic horse culture. The recent reports that transients are invading the Great Turtle, taking what is not rightfully theirs, is an abomination. Our borders to the north and south are vulnerable and should be closed and guarded to the maximum fullest extent. I'm not referring to the U.S.-Mexico border. What I'm reminding you of is the topic that was once at the tip of everyone's tongues and became taboo after the Hurley-He incident of 1983. That's right, I dare to remind you of the transdimensional swamp portals. These portals found in the swamps that straddle the Louisiana-Texas border and the darkest woods around Wawa, Ontario, must be closed down with dynamite and patrolled to prevent any future transdimensional fissure transit. The cost of these closures would be minimal, as the majority of the expenditures could be reclaimed by selling off the hides of these horrific interlopers once they are trapped on our own dimension and culled. The attacks on our homeland must stop. These most recent events serve not only to warn us to be vigilant against Yeti attack, but should also be a grisly reminder of the summertime interdimensional attacks that, for reasons that I can only guess, are to protect the seasonal tourist trade perpetrated by El Chupacabra and Le Lutin, that so savagely destroyed, spooked, and otherwise irritated several livery horses in recent summers. Besides, I've heard these beasts only come to our world to breed, and once they've finished bespoiling our precious island, they prey upon our livestock and pet children. Well, I say, not in my backyard. This has been Straits Talk, and I'm Daniel Calvin.
Message to...
I was just that I can drive by 4 cell phone towers on my way home. I only have 1 bar of signal. F*** you, AT&T.
New message 3.
So, Calvin, that's an AC racket. You go to one there with that big, great show of nonsense. But remember this. I'm not going to be there to tell you this time. You go to Pokey, you're on your own. You better not mention my name.
Now for having an extra leg to stand on, paramedic sued for stealing a man's foot. A former St. Lucie County Fire District firefighter paramedic who took a man's foot and part of his leg from an Interstate 95 crash scene in 2008 has been sued by the foot's owner. The MT has admitted she took the foot belonging to Carl Lambert of Brevard County, who was seriously injured in the 2008 accident. But she did so she could help train her body recovery dog. Attorneys say that the act was outrageous and went beyond bounds of decency. It was odious, utterly intolerable in a civilized society. It was an unrecognizable mass of flesh, she said. It wasn't a clean cut. You couldn't even recognize it was a foot. If I had thought it was somehow reattachable and usable, I would have gone to my commander. Asked at the same hearing if the leg could have been reattached, Lambert said, "We'll never know now." And now for timely relevant news. Bigfoot filmmaker sues New Hampshire over free speech. Amateur filmmaker Jonathan Doyle is suing the state of New Hampshire after park rangers told him he needed a permit to walk on a mountain dressed as Bigfoot. The 30-year-old artist who was filming Walker's reaction to Bigfoot sightings claims the decision violates his freedom of speech. His case has received backing from the American Civil Liberties Union. He refused to obey the ranger's orders, claiming it would disadvantage other artists who want to use the mountain in the future, and instead lodged a complaint with the New Hampshire Civil Liberties Union. Doyle explained, "What about people who are not professional artists?
but who will be and are coming in to their own expression and inspiration by using the mountain. I love and respect our mountain, but this situation is absurd and uncalled for. Doyle also pointed out that no officials had complained when he made a similar Bigfoot film on the same mountain in 2009. Talk about government overstepping its authority. If you're out and about on Mackinac Island tomorrow, Saturday, be sure to stop by the VI at 1 o'clock for street hockey with Jamie Bino and hot dogs and hot chocolate as a memorial for a great guy who'll be sadly missed, Bobby Roach. Following that, there'll be a bonfire down at the end of the boardwalk past the school. There'll be a burning of a piano in his honor, as well as a vigil at 11 o'clock with Father Jim Williams. Hope to see you there. Bobby was a great guy, and he'd really appreciate if you were.